In this video, we'll learn how total currency flow can impact the money supply. The total currency flow on the balance of payments tracks the net flow of money based on international transactions and goods, services, and assets. If there is a net inflow of money, then the money supply will increase. If there is a net outflow of money, then the money supply will decrease. Let's look at each situation to better understand why. If there's a net inflow of money, how will this result in an increase in the money supply? Let's see. To purchase Canadian goods, foreign buyers must exchange their local currency for Canadian dollars. To purchase foreign goods, Canadian buyers must exchange their Canadian dollars for foreign currency. If the value of Canadian exports to foreign buyers exceeds the value of imports made by Canadian buyers, then there will be an increase in the amount of Canadian dollars circulating, and hence an increase in the money supply. Next, let's look at how a net outflow of money will cause a decrease in the money supply. Again, we'll use the example of Canada. To purchase Canadian goods, foreign buyers must exchange their local currency for Canadian dollars. To purchase foreign goods, Canadian buyers must exchange their Canadian dollars for foreign currency. If the value of imports purchased by Canadian buyers exceeds the value of exports made by Canadian firms, then there will be a decrease in the amount of Canadian dollars circulating, and thus a decrease in the money supply. Here's an example for you to try. Assume the money supply is currently 1 million Canadian dollars in Canada. Now assume the money supply is currently 5 million US dollars in the US. The exchange rate is 2 Canadian dollars to 1 US dollar. Canada exports 200,000 Canadian dollars, or 100,000 US dollars, worth of maple syrup to the US. The US exports 50,000 US dollars, or 100,000 Canadian dollars, worth of sneakers to Canada. Ceteris paribus, what happens to the money supply in Canada and the US? Pause the video here and try to see if you can figure it out. Otherwise, continue playing to see the answer. Canada exports 200,000 Canadian dollars, or 100,000 US dollars, worth of maple syrup to the US. The US exports 50,000 US dollars, or 100,000 Canadian dollars, worth of sneakers to Canada. So Canada's starting money supply was 1 million Canadian dollars. The value of their exports was 200,000 Canadian dollars. The value of their imports was less, at 100,000 Canadian dollars. So Canada has an increase in the money supply, and their ending money supply is 1.1 million Canadian dollars. So as you can see, the money supply has risen. More money has now entered Canada than has left. But let's look at what happens in the US. The US money supply started at 5 million US dollars. They exported $50,000 American dollars worth of goods. They imported $100,000 or US dollars worth of goods. So more money has left than entered the United States. So the US ending money supply is 4.95 million US dollars. So you can see the money supply in the US has fallen. By now, you should have a better understanding of total currency flow and how it can impact the money supply. If you have any questions, leave them below and let's try and answer them together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.